So, before we actually, handle the heat to be moving, we can actually just do the attack. Let's create the rotation for us. So each unit controller will actually have a holder space. And we're going to be rotating that. So, for the player, it's very easy. So let's, you know what? Let's rename this tick player movement or just tick player. So for the controller, for the player, it's very easy. If you are interacting, don't do anything. If you are interacting, if direction dot x lower than 0, actually, we could just say vector 3 Euler's vector 3.0, and if x is lower than 0, Euler's dot z, if 380, then folder dot local Euler angles equals Euler. And that's it. Not that, because we have to assign the holder. And nice thing with this. Okay, here's one thing. First of all, we need to know if we're moving. So let's just check once it's moving. Not to be direction the square magnitude higher than 0. So is moving true. And if you're moving, change the direction. Otherwise, just the direction you have. It's going to be kind of similar with this guy, but changing a little bit. Okay. Perfect. So let's create the attack. For example, what I want to do, to go on my okay, and on attack one, I actually want to be moving slightly forward. Okay, so this from here to here, I want to be a little bit forward, something like that. Okay, from here, I'll still be at 0 here. It will play like that. So it's a little bit aggressive. Now, that is entirely a design decision. I don't really know what the original game had it. And another thing we can do is for our position at least, we can do right agent and for both of them. Just set it to linear. Okay, this is entirely a design decision. I don't know what the original game was doing on this specific attack, but I want to make this so I move around. So, for example, now you can see that I'm moving. So, let's say I'm over here. Technically, because I was moving forward, I should have stayed forward, but of course, that's not the case. So, how do we do that? We can go on our animator hook. I'm going to assign the delta position here. And we can know the delta position from if we take on animator move, delta position can be animator.deltaPosition Subdivide that by time dot delta time. Then on my unit controller, let's try if we are interacting, the velocity we should be applying now. Let's see what will happen if it is the delta position. Now, there is one thing that you need to know. You should be moving this to get the root motion from the 2D script. You should be moving the root transform, not the sprite renderer, the entire root transform. So let's make sure that's the case. Mic position. What we change this group. Yeah. Okay, let's hit play. And let's see. And yeah. So as you can see, this actually works pretty great. Okay. It's pretty cool. Awesome. So with that in mind, we could just do now. On the enemy, we can say public void pick enemy. Although I think, yeah, okay, you know what? Let's go on the AI handler and we are setting up the destination. Actually, I don't want to set up the destination. I want to just say unit controller pick player time dot delta time and direction just say vector 3.0. Let's bring this guy closer. This then animation. Okay. Okay. For Hert, we'll start here and he should be moving backward. Maybe that can work. Of course, again, this is entirely a design decision. It's up to you. If that's too much or a hit. Maybe do the pixel. Three max two something like that. Okay. Just so that you can do more attack. And so now I could basically just probably just hit him and he will go back. Yep. Okay, so now that work kind of worked good. Although I think at least for Mikey's attack, it shouldn't move him. At least for this attack, it shouldn't move him. So let's just go over here and remove the property entirely. Okay, so now the rest is pretty much, you know, design decisions. Let's put the sort order to actually show us the icon. Hold on there. Yeah. Wait. We actually do not update. So we're going by one. Then something I'm sort of order. Actually going to do it plus 10. Point 2. Since yeah, it gets rounded, so it doesn't matter a lot, but there's cases like this that a player will at least and first tag. Why? Or not doing it. Drop something. That. Yeah, you can see why that good, because these values are pretty low already, so I'm going to multiply them by 100, add 10 afterwards. That is, so if you have a layer of layers, you can still stack them above. Okay. So this if layers now when I hit him he always can press and pay off. Okay, that's pretty cool. So that works pretty great. So yeah, that's for root motion basically, and we can actually do the same thing for the thugs attack obviously without doing much. So let's do here, let's have him move here. Yeah. Maybe for a little. So, yes, I guess. Okay. We can make. Well, that's okay. So on the AI controller, let's just say every 5 seconds. Five. If stack time greater than 0. Stack time minus time, else attack time equals 5, and here controller player. Attack. So every 5 seconds he's going to play that is. Now I don't have the hit animation mic. But yeah, you can see that this list. He was going back for some reason. We should, of course, check that. Yeah, controller, though. You're not interacting. Before you do that. You can probably change the timer to something else if you are interacting. Maybe like half a second, whatever. Otherwise, it's just going to lose you. Going to attack intense. So now, if I just keep attacking him, he will never. What? But he didn't break his body. Okay, so that's it for this part. I need to clean up the Mikey. Mikey here before we can do what else. But you know what? Let's do one more thing. Let's check the distance. Float distance from a position. The target position. Okay, so if distance is greater than some attack distance, attack distance, let's say 2, greater attack distance, then that is the target position. Now, the tick player now is actually an issue because we want to be running this, but we do not want to be passing direction. Especially when we just pass. We could just do a handler agent dot desired velocity. So it will assign his velocity that he's actually saying. Okay, so if you are below this, if you are below, let's change this to attack time every second. But we still should be like, should be. Although I think. Because we are overriding with the interaction, yeah, we can give it the caption. Okay, let's see. And technically, since he is going to be, we're going to be passing a velocity, he should be also playing the walk animation, or his walk animation. We do. It's just the attack distance is too high, I think. Either that or we keep adding velocity when we don't know velocity. Yeah, so let's do agent or agent controller agent dot is top just true. Okay, let's add track dog distance just to see how close they in attack is attacking. And let's change his speed 0.2 or something. Okay, 2 is way too much for attack. Also, There's a couple of issues here. So what I do is be to say 0.6 for attack distance, that this here, and attack time maybe even. Maybe say attack rate 5. Obviously, we could just say minimum max just to keep it interesting. This will work. Okay, so I think we are done with this part as well. We can now attack, we can actually move. We are going to make this, I need to clean up the animation icon. You can see that because now when he attacks, I can't interrupt him. Yeah, it needs to be thought of a little bit better, because we should know if he can be damaged or not, not if he can be damaged. This is really okay. So that is a base for doing some attacks. We can add him, we can add some damage. So on the next part, we're going to add the heat for this guy and expand a little bit more on what we already have. So that's it for this part. As always, you know what to do. Like, subscribe, and if you like to see more stuff, more videos, more series, more of everything, of course, keep supporting me on Patreon so we can continue making all these nice things and make some new things as well. I'll see you on the next one.